typically you think, oh, only bats can make that up. But I went back the other day and I saw to get the photographs. And not only did the photographs are dead accurate, there I am, I'm eating the noodle soup, you know, you buy, and I'm listening it on a, got little speakers actually. But there I am on Lake Baikal in Irkutsk. And I've got that, and so it all really happened.
Maybe he didn't have the ability.
Well, he's been a friend for that many years. His family are friends of mine. I'm very close to them and I love them dearly. But he is a partner now. He's a complete partner. He is completely in control of his powers. He is, you know, not many people will have Leonardo's life. And many people who have that life go off the rails. They become self-destructive. And part of it's the fact that he's had the maturity. You know, he used to get a lot of flack for the so-called posse. They're just his friends. The people I see Leonardo with, I have been seeing him with for 20 years or 18 years or whatever it is. His parents, his family, it's all the same. It's like nothing's changed. And I think he's both extraordinarily evolved. He's very mature. He's articulate. He has two great things he's committed to, acting and the environment. He's ridiculously credible in all the things he does, extraordinarily so. And I think he gets to, he's maligned and he gets unfair judgment just because people go like, they look on the outside and they go, he can't possibly be a good person as well, or a nice guy, or decent. And he's all those things, you know. But he has his own, I'm sure he has his own inner life issues that none of us can guess, but they won't be ours.
That and actually make a movie, you know, like
the book's like that. I mean, Gatsby, when Nick goes, it's Gatsby, it's Nick's perspective. He goes there, Gatsby's like this Trimalchio, it's Studio 54, it's wild, it's crazy, it's taking him around. And as the film goes on, it ends up with, you know, it ends up with five actors in a room for 10 pages acting in a room upstairs. That's it. Like, that's your special effect. How many movies have acting scenes that are longer than 2 minutes, right? So we just keep stripping it away. The music isn't arbitrary. I didn't do it to be sell records, although that's good. We like that. I'm into soundtracks. We did it because Fitzgerald put jazz and African-American street music in his books. And everyone said, that's just fad, and why are you doing this, and it's Well, I wanted the film not to feel nostalgic. So if Fitzgerald coined the phrase the jazz age, this is the hip hop age. And you know, you want to go hip hop, go and meet the chairman of the board, that would be Mr. Jay-Z. And he was an awesome collaborator and he's extraordinarily smart and he got the book and he was able to sum it up in about five seconds. Anything that comes out of Jay's mouth usually sounds poetic, funny, or both. You know, I worked with my wife. She worked with an old friend of ours, Mucha Prada, on collaborating on a lot of the frocks. It was the jazz age. I mean, you know, it wasn't called the nice, polite, minimal grey 20s. It was called the roaring 20s. And they roared.